Good evening, everyone. My name is Paul Flynn. I'm the superintendent of Coldwater Community Schools, and I'm very excited to welcome you tonight to a wonderful evening of giving. This is always my favorite night of the year in any school district because we work very hard, our students work very hard, and our community has a time to shine and show its support of our kids through scholarships, gifts, and opportunities. So before we begin tonight, I'd like to challenge those students tonight, upwards of 90 this year that are receiving at least one award. Last year, over $381,000 was awarded to students, and I understand this year is even higher. But my challenge to the students is this: when you go off and you become famous in your own right, don't forget about the gift of giving, that the people here today find it very important to invest in you as the future of not our community, but any community in which you land. So hopefully, you will reciprocate that when you become well-established in your field, or you'll work with community organizations in order to raise those funds to give back to kids and community. This is a wonderful evening, and you're not here to see me, so I would like to introduce Mrs. Dina Courtright from the American Legion Auxiliary Poppy Sales Scholarship as our first sponsor tonight.
Welcome. It's always fun to be here. It's always amazing to see how many young people have a goal in mind, even if they don't know exactly what they want to be when they finish growing up yet. Every year, the American Legion Auxiliary here in Coldwater does three scholarships. They're not a lot of money, but if nothing else, it'll buy stuff for your dorms or whatever. We do give them directly to the students. They are $300 each, and we hope they will at least ease some of the cost that it's going to take for getting your first step into college. And if in the next, this next weekend, if you see anybody out with poppies that they're offering, please, please take one. It's strictly donation. All money goes towards our veterans. This year's scholarships are going to Owen Mitchell Callahan, which I kind of freaked out because I had the wrong name, but Samuel Lahr and alumni Ilsa Katz. Okay, you get which one?
Owen.
If they want to dash them like that, just take it back to Jessica.
Oh, shit, they came to me.
You must be Sam.
Thank you.
Our next presenter is Tom Schweitzer from the Coldwater Early Bird Exchange Club.
Good evening. Thanks for being here this evening to celebrate this event with your sons or daughters or granddaughter or grandson or cousins or niece or nephew or next door neighbor, whoever. Thank you for being here this evening. It does mean a lot to them, although they may never say so. I represent the Coldwater Early Bird Exchange Club here in Coldwater. It's an offshoot of the Noon Exchange Club, which was started by Al Klein, who used to be a principal here in Coldwater School Systems. I've been a member for 12 years, and I've been on the scholarship committee for that length of time as well. A criteria for selection is to be a graduate of a Branch County school, to have a minimum of a 2.5 GPA, to have financial need, to have two letters of recommendation, to write a personal statement, to be a U.S. citizen, and to go into a field that is child-related. The Early Bird Exchange has a vision of making a strong America, safe communities, and unified people. We have a mission of inspiring communities to become better places to live. Our core values include family, community, and country. Our motto is unity for service. We place an emphasis on child abuse prevention and patriotism. Our projects include the Healing Hill of Hope. Have any of you heard of the Healing Hill of Hope? In July, for the whole month of July, we will be having USA flags and child abuse flags on the hill in front of the Naomi Davis home. This year, we will be putting those up on June 27th, which represent 95 substantiated cases of child abuse within Branch County, and which also represents 78 children placed in foster care. You may or may not believe this statistic, but Branch County is the fourth highest county in the state of Michigan for identifying child abuse. I think that's a good thing. That means we are doing something and we're not just sweeping things under the table. Some of the projects that we do, as I said, the Healing Hill. If we have any runners on the 4th of July, we host a 5K run. We put Valentine baskets out. We do Toys for Tots. We give the Valentine baskets to the Commission on Aging, the Union City American Legion, Veterans of Foreign Affairs, and we sell tickets here at Coldwater for all the home football games and all the boys and girls varsity basketball games. That's the money that we use to provide 4 scholarships throughout the county. This year, I'm happy to say that we have 2 Coldwater students, Lily Bachheim, did I say that right? And Jayla Sloan. Our next presenter is the Coldwater High School Interact Club Scholarship by Miss Sarah Davis.
My name is Sarah Davis, and I am the advisor of the Interact Club. I'm proud to be the advisor of this club because it focuses on the principle of working to make the school, the community, and the world a better place for us all. A student told me recently that it is our responsibility to educate others and to eradicate stereotypes and prejudice in our world. This statement really moved me. Throughout the last 4 years, we have worked on projects to help bring clean water to Yemen, to help the victims of earthquakes in Turkey and Syria, and currently we are helping to build homes for people in the Dominican Republic. These service projects help us to better understand the world and, most importantly, to educate others about the world we live in. We volunteer at many local events and organizations as well as help the community. Through food drives, we visit the elderly, we plant flowers, we fold clothes, we stock shelves, we pick up trash, and somewhere in the middle of all this service, students really come to value and enjoy helping others. The idea of service above self finally makes sense, and it resonates with us. They enjoy giving their time and talents to help others, and this is when I realize that I have fulfilled my responsibility as their advisor. This year, we are truly honored and humbled to recognize and award three young women from Interact who understand and embody this philosophy. They will all create a positive change in the world. It is with great pride that we award Sharifa Abouali, Bray Mohammed, and Hannah Stevens with scholarships. Next up, we have my friend, Mrs. Kristen Neswicki from the Good, Better, Best store.
Good evening. I am Kristen Neswicki. I'm director of Good, Better, Best Shop of Branch County. On behalf of our volunteers and community members like yourself who have donated gently used items, we are here to give 7 of our 12 $1,000 scholarships to 3 graduates of the class of 2024 and 4 alumni of CHS. Good, Better, Best is a group of volunteers who collect gently used donations from community members. We sell them in a storefront to raise money to support educational efforts across Branch County. We have been able to grant many individuals and organizations for materials or financial support for educational purposes. Since opening June of 2020, this group of volunteers is proud to say that we have given back over $250,000 to Branch County. It's amazing that all of these funds are raised by unwanted items in our community that you generously donate. Our Grants and Scholarship Committee is proud to award 3 of the 12 $1,000 scholarships to graduates of class of 2024. Stephen Koval, Haley Price, and Cooper Nelson. And we have 4 alumni from Coldwater High School: Jillian Hauber, Alexandra Stewart, Sydney Gallup, and Jonathan Neswicki. Congratulations to the scholarship recipients. We wish you the best in your pursuit of higher education. Please look for us on Facebook, Good, Better, Best Shop, to find out how you can support the work that we do in our county. And again, Craig, congratulations to the class of 2024. Oh yes, I need to introduce our next guest. So from the Coldwater Township Sunrise Rotary is Miss Sherry Devers.
Good evening. I am going to be giving out scholarships for Sunrise Rotary and also Kellogg Community College, so I'll be up here for a couple minutes. Not a long time, but. Sunrise Rotary has done so much for this community. Those Interact kids you see get scholarships, they are part of our Sunrise Rotary. We have a Promise program that is for students, adult learners that are taking allied health or skilled trades, And this scholarship fund, it's called the Promise Program, was started 5 years ago, and now our endowment has reached $500,000 this year. So all this money goes back to Branch County students to better their education. On behalf of the Sunrise Rotary, we select four students for $1,000 scholarships from Coldwater High School. Service above self means leaving our egos at the door and do what is best for the people we are serving. Erica, Lucas, Sharif, Bersha demonstrate they understand the community needs by their strong work ethics, leadership skills, and positive attitudes for volunteering and serving others. So, Lucas Wishmeyer, Erica Rucker, Sharif Abu, and Bersha Ahmed, please come forward. You are?
I'm Lucas Wishmeyer.
And so, here's the first one. It says here. Let's double check. Okay, now I'll put my KCC hat on. Good evening. I'm Sherry Devers. I'm the Grawl Center Director here at KCC in Coldwater. If you haven't been to our building lately, we are still open, but we're under major construction, getting a lot of renovations done. So we're still running classes. It may look strange when you walk in the door, but we're still there. It's my pleasure to be here to recognize Coldwater High School graduates for the academic performance, leadership, and community service demonstrated by their submission of an application to Kellogg Community College Foundation Scholarship Program by the priority funding deadline of March 1st. All applicants are reviewed by a committee appointed by the foundation. On behalf of KCC and the KCC Foundation, I am proud to present the following scholarships. Will the students come forward? The KCC Foundation Scholarship and KCC Endowment Scholarship to Gracie Flynn. The John B. Fares Memorial Scholarship, Dr. G. Edward Harry Memorial Scholarship, Jill Stewart Scholarship for Grawl Center students, and the Richard S. Clare Pohl Memorial Scholarship to Miriam Agabera. In closing, KCC Foundation will provide additional scholarships awards in August for students who submitted scholarship applications after March 1st and until the deadline of July 31st. Again, congratulations, graduates. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. Thank you. Next up is Coldwater High School Astro Club Scholarship, Mrs. Jan Storrs.
Thank you. As a charter member of ALTRUSA, 42 years ago, we sat together and said, what can we do to help our community? And we've done lots of things like the other community services clubs, and likewise, we wanted to start a scholarship, which we did, and I have the great honor of presenting it today. I did something a little bit different. I focused on the student rather than ALTRUSA. I hope you don't mind, but she's a wonderful gal, and I want you to know a lot about her. It's my great privilege is to introduce to you our ASTRA, which stands for Ability, Service, Training, Responsibility, and Achievement, Ms. Abrar Ahmed. So, you gotta come close, because there's a visual in this, okay? Abrar is a dynamo. Less than 5 feet tall, she is a force to be reckoned with. Don't get in her way. Her presence, intelligence, dependability, creativity, work ethic is amazing. There is no task she is afraid to take on, be it from other students or teachers or community members. She is not afraid. Her ability to organize and bring people together makes others stand in awe. Besides being the secretary of Coldwater High School ASTRA, she also is a member of a gazillion other clubs. She's a officer of a gazillion other clubs. She's involved in the community service, the brand new community center in town. She's in fact our first student board member of the Coldwater Community Center, which is now being revitalized downtown. And she has served on the organizing board, because I had to invite her because she was doing more than the board was doing, of the Multicultural Festival, which is being held in town tomorrow. So you can thank this young lady here for a lot of things that are happening tomorrow. On top of all that, she finds time to work part-time at the library. Abrar is clearly one of Coldwater's most impressive students. She is the student you always know you can depend on to step up and follow through. She is the student whose mind is flying while the others are still thinking. She is a student who fearlessly does an incredible job in all she takes on. The adults of the world could take some lessons from her. Again, as much as I applaud her accomplishments, I also think she is a downright nice person, honest, caring, hardworking. She opens her heart to all. I can happily say she has made my life more full.
Aww.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. My name is Cannon Neal. I'm a trust assistant at Central Bank and Trust. And tonight, I'll be presenting three scholarships, so get comfortable, if you will. First is the Clement F. Malovey Educational Scholarship. This was created in 2009 for students in Branch County. As a longtime resident of Branch County, a businessman and an avid farmer, he established a scholarship for students who attained high academic achievement while maintaining at least part-time employment within 12 months prior to the application. This will be the 15th year that the scholarship has been awarded to students, totaling over $1.6 million. This scholarship is renewable for past recipients that have continued employment while attending college. This year, Century Bank and Trust, trustee of the Clement Malovey Educational Scholarship, will be presenting scholarships totaling over $119,000 in Branch County. $38,000 is for current and past Coldwater High School students. Today, I am pleased to present 19 scholarships to the following recipients: Gabriella Bookmeyer, Zachary Coughing, Stephen Koval II, Gracie Finn, Chase Moore, Haley Price, Hannah Stevens, Isabella Tenney, Gracie Vaughn, Taylor West, Lucas Wishmeyer, and for our alumni, we have Caleb Brown. Carter Collins. Brady Crabtree. Brandon Downs. Sterling Haylett. Griffin Persales. Riley Rice. And Kara Volkmer. For the second scholarship I'll be presenting is the Percy and Helen Taylor Memorial Scholarship. Longtime residents of Coldwater, Helen and Percy established a scholarship trust in 2004 for high school seniors seeking higher education. Throughout this scholarship, they have contributed nearly $2.4 million to Branch County students over the past 20 years. This year, Century Bank and Trust, trustee of the Helen and Percy Taylor Scholarship Trust, will be presenting $144,300 to students in Branch County. Tonight, I am pleased to present $55,000 in scholarships, which is divided amongst 22 of the following recipients. Sharif Aboli. Grace Johnson. Bushra Ahmed. Caroline Miller. Maram Al-Ghabri. Bra Muhammad. Shatha Al-Thabani. Rokaya Manasser. Lily Bachheim. Gaith Musa. Dawson Brown. Cooper Nelson. Catalina Cardenas. Matthew Nichols. Morgan Dancer. Mackenzie Scheid. Madison DeLong. Jayla Sloan. Talon Eberts. Zachary Speaker. Abigail Govier. And lastly, Maya Walensky. Lastly, I'll be presenting the Verbe E. Harkness Memorial Scholarship. The Verbe Harkness Scholarship Fund was established in 2002 for Branch County graduates pursuing higher education. Verbe cared a great deal about continuing education for graduates in our community and wanted to help contribute to their futures. To be eligible for this scholarship, the recipient must have attended a high academic achievement throughout high school, possesses a high morale character, and must demonstrate financial need for the scholarship. The scholarship was renewable for all 4 years while maintaining a B average. This year's scholarship is for $1,500 and is rewarded to Zachary Grimes. Next up, I'd like to introduce one BJ West of the Coldwater Noon Club.
Evening, everyone. I am here to represent my club that I'm very proud to be a part of, the Coldwater Noon Club. We will be handing out six $1,000 scholarships today. We are a club that our primary fundraising event is the our variety show at the Tibbetts every February. We are very proud, very thankful for the community. With that event, we generally can raise over $40,000 between the community, the businesses in the community that we're so thankful for. So without further ado, our first award is Shatha Alathbathini. I'm sorry. Addison Arver. Morgan Dancer. Carson Snyder. I didn't have an assistant like Century did.
You're welcome. Carson, congrats, buddy. Good job.
I'm sorry, Isabella Tenney. And alumni Abby Steele. Okay, next up will be the Branch County Association of Realtors Cliffy Bowers Memorial Scholarship Fund by Mrs. Angie Marsh.
Hi, I'm Angie Marsh and this is Jessica Derschel. We are representing the Branch County Association for Realtors. For over six decades, our association has served unwavering as the voice of real estate in Branch County, nurturing communities and fostering growth since 1958. Today, it is my distinct honor to pay tribute to the remarkable legacy of Cliffy Bowers by presenting the Cliffy Bowers Memorial Scholarship. Cliffy was a cherished member of the Branch County Association of Realtors. He possessed a radiant energy that could illuminate any room. His passion for community service was palpable, as he wholeheartedly engaged in numerous fundraising endeavors, leaving a mark on the hearts of all who knew him. Tragically, we lost Cliffy in a car accident in 2017, leaving a void in our hearts and community. Yet his memory shines through with the Cliffy Bowers Memorial Scholarship Fundraiser, a testament to the impact of his life. Since its inception in 2012, this scholarship has empowered countless graduating seniors in Branch County, awarding over 96 scholarships to date. Today, Cliffy's legacy, it brings immense pride to announce that the Branch County Association of Realtors is awarding 12 $750 scholarships from the Cliffy Bowers Memorial Scholarship to deserving graduating seniors who embody the spirit of community, resilience, and academic excellence. We are proud to award the $750 from the Cliffy Bower Memorial Scholarship to the following seniors. We have Aisha Abdullah, Cloud Ahmed, Liam Bullen, Owen Callahan, Catalina Cardenas, Zach Coffing, Hannah Holt, Sam Lahr, Cooper Nelson, Mackenzie Scheib, Hannah Stevens, and Maya Walensky.
Thank you.
Our next scholarship is from the CHS Class of 1981 Scholarship. In 2011, at their 30th class reunion, the CHS Class of 1981 Scholarship was established by the remaining members of the Class of 1981 in honor of their fellow classmates who have since passed. The recipient is to be a deserving member of the senior class at Coldwater High School. The 2024 CH Class of 1981 Scholarship is presented to Eric Rucker. Next up is Executive Director of the Branch County Community Foundation, Erica Heminger.
Hi, good evening, everybody. As Angie said, My name is Erica Heminger, and I'm the Executive Director of the Branch County Community Foundation. I just want to talk really quickly about our scholarships. I know we don't want to be here all night, but in most cases, the scholarships that are being awarded tonight were created in memory of somebody who is no longer with us. Either the family is honoring their loved one by setting aside money for you all to pursue higher education, or the person themselves have left money in their will or trust so that others will also have the opportunity for higher education. And if you think about that for a moment, it's kind of remarkable, right? I mean, somebody that you don't know and somebody that you will never meet was thinking about you and believing in you so much and in your future that they wanted to help you. For the Branch County Community Foundation, helping maintain an individual or a family's local legacy is an honor. And when you're awarded the scholarships tonight, you become a part of that. You're honored to carry those legacies forward and know that as you start this exciting new time in your life and you go off to pursue your hopes and dreams, that you get to carry a little bit of their hopes and dreams with you as well. This year, a total of $29,000 was awarded to 17 graduating seniors and CHS alumni. When I call your name, please come to the podium to get your certificate. First is Cooper Nelson. And Cooper is the recipient of the Jeanette Mulby Stevens Scholarship and the John and Marguerite Kenyon Scholarship. Morgan Dancer. Morgan's the recipient of the John and Marguerite Kenyon Scholarship. Lucas Wischmeyer. Thank you. Lucas is the recipient of the James E. Rice Memorial Scholarship. Mariah Nottingham. And Mariah is the recipient of the Steve Grahalski All My Trust in God Memorial Scholarship, the Lucille Burnside Scholarship, and the Jeanette Mulby Stevens Scholarship. Caroline Miller. And Caroline is the recipient of the Osama Goko Scholarship. And then, Brea Mohammed. And Brea is the recipient of the Osama Goko Scholarship. Kimberly Riviera Tovar. The recipient of the Steve Grahalski All My Trust in God Memorial Scholarship. Bushra Ahmed. Recipient of the Weston McCurley Girth Scholarship. Catalina Cardenas. Recipient of the Weston McCurley Girth Scholarship. Lily Bachheim, recipient of the Lucille Burnside Scholarship. Eric Rucker, recipient of the Emory Seacrest Scholarship. St- Stephen Koble, recipient of the Hillquist Family Scholarship. And Ian Stowe, recipient of the Max W. Benjamin Memorial Scholarship. And then I would like to also announce the CHS alumni who have received scholarships. Alexa Omo, the Mildred G. Hutchins Fund, Kira Volkmer, James E. Rice Memorial Scholarship, and the Mildred G. Hutchins Fund, and Alexis Galliers, the Branch County Community Foundation Catalyst Scholarship, and the John and Marguerite Kenyon Scholarship. Oh, sorry, also Kobe Stewart, he got the Max W. Benjamin Memorial Scholarship. But congratulations to all of the recipients, and up next is Mike with the Branch Area Career Center. Perfect. Thank you.
Good evening. As Mr. Flynn said at the beginning, it's always an exciting time to see the community support for our students at events like this, and we're excited to hand out some scholarships from the Branch Area Career Center tonight. First, to Aisha Abdullah, the BACC Student Endowment Fund Scholarship for $1,000, the Education Profession Scholarship for $500, and the Jennifer Horde, Katie Rassler Early Education Memorial Scholarship for $400. Thank you. Khalid Ahmed, Health Profession Scholarship, $500. Sydney Alatori, the BACC Student Endowment Fund Scholarship for $1,000. Catalina Cardenas, the Lighthouse Funeral Home Scholarship, $250. Bella Carrion, the Education Profession Scholarship, $500. The Jennifer Horde, Kate Rassler, Early Education Memorial Scholarship for $400. Lily Cook, Health Profession Scholarship for $500. Amy Cortez, Criminal Justice Sarah Irene Haylett Jones Memorial Scholarship, $2,000. The Jaron Frederick Criminal Justice Memorial Scholarship, $500. Skylar Danbury, the BACC FFA Alumni Scholarship, $250, and the DeKalb Scholarship, $250. Founham Dompierre, Aaron Levitt Scholarship, $500, BACC Student Endowment Fund Scholarship, $1,000. The Coldwater Swap Meet and Car Show Scholarship, $500. The Kenneth Stutzman Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Helena Evislage, BACC FFA Alumni Scholarship, $250. And the DeKalb Scholarship, $250. Gracie Finn, the Bernie Banke Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Hannah Folk, the Business Management Marketing Technology Scholarship, $675. And the Business Management Marketing and Technology Southern Michigan Bank and Trust Scholarship for $675. Brandon Jones, the Coach E.B. Homestore Scholarship, $1,000. Elise Kinney, the Health Profession Scholarship, $250. Madison Kling, the Health Profession Scholarship, $500. Jocelyn Martinez, the BACC FFA Alumni Scholarship, $250, and the DeKalb Scholarship, $500. Aubrey McLaughlin, Health Profession Scholarships, $500. Chase Moore, the BACC Student Endowment Fund Scholarship, $1,000, and the CBPU Scholarship for $1,000. Hadil Nasser, the Health Profession Scholarship, $500. Mariah Nottingham, the Health Profession Scholarship, $250. Ethan Parker, BACC Student Endowment Fund Scholarship for $1,000. And the Jaron Frederick Criminal Justice Memorial Scholarship for $500. Haley Price, the Bio Scholarship, $500. Jack Rudin, BACC FFA Alumni Scholarship, $250. The Bernie Banke Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. The Earl Mock Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. And the Mitchell Miller Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Yaya Umari, BACC Student Endowment Fund Scholarship, $1,000. Coldwater Swap Meet and Car Show Scholarship, $500. Taylor West, BACC Student Endowment Fund Scholarship, $1,000. And the Business Management, Marketing, and Technology Southern Michigan Bank and Trust Scholarship for $500. Emerson Young, the Education Profession Scholarship, $500. And the Jennifer Hoard, Kate Rassler Early Education Memorial Scholarship, $400. Yesterday we had the opportunity to send off our seniors at the BACC, and I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate the Coldwater Class of 2024 and wish you all the best on your future endeavors. Next up is Mr. Brian Shirk with the Branch County 4-H Scholarship.
Good evening. My name is Brian Shirk. I'm a director of the Branch County Fair Board, a 4-H leader, and a member of Branch County Junior Livestock. So I'm giving out two awards tonight. The Branch County 4-H Scholarship is awarded to an outstanding 4-H member that has went through a big application, lots of interviews. It involves all their 4-H activities. 4-H is more than just showing livestock at the Branch County Fair. There's leadership projects, activities, community involvement. And this year, our Branch County 4-H Scholarship Award winner is Colden Marvin. Okay. The next scholarship I'm going to give out is from the Branch County Junior Livestock Association. Branch County Junior Livestock Association proudly serves to develop and support Branch County and 4-H youth livestock programs. Our organization consists of both adults and youth volunteers who dedicate their time in providing clinics, shows, and other opportunities to assist local youth in developing their passion in raising, caring for, and showing livestock. Each year, our committee members proudly present local seniors who have been involved with 4-H to advance their schooling in a field of their choice. This year, we are proud to present the following CHS seniors with scholarships: Colden Marvin and Jack Rudin. Next up is Mrs. Reif from the Kiwanis Club of Coldwater.
Good evening. To the students sitting here tonight, congratulations on all of your accomplishments. Two things you should know. You've really been very successful in your career to be here tonight. And the second thing is, it doesn't stop here. You're gonna have a long road ahead of you, but it's gonna be a great road, and it's gonna be full of a lot of fun and a lot of new experiences. So congratulations. To the family members sitting here, you've obviously done something right for your students to be here tonight. So congratulations to you, because the last 18 years of your life has focused on this evening and your accomplishments. So congratulations to you. I'm here to present two scholarships on behalf of the Kiwanis Club of Coldwater. There are $1,000 scholarships apiece. This is the first year that we have given out scholarships, so we're very excited that the class of 2024 is our first group of students. The two students, when you come up, I'd like you to stand over here because we have a photography person in our midst, and we have to get a photo for our social media or we'll be in trouble. So Brea Muhammad is our recipient, and Lucas Wishmeyer. And the next person to present is Mrs. Victoria Duda from Southern Michigan Bank.
Good evening. I would like to introduce Sherry Cochran. She's going to be doing the speeches. I'm going to be handing out the awards. I have a senior this year, so there's a lot of familiar faces in the crowd, and I'm just honored to be here. So, Sherry, would you please?
Yes, I would be happy to do that.
Good evening. We have a lot of scholarships to give out tonight. Yay! So the first one we're going to do is the Hensley Scholarship. The Hensley Scholarship Fund was created under the Gladys Hensley Irrevocable Trust in 2007. Gladys and her husband, Gerald, moved to Coldwater in 1939. I was not born then. They owned and operated the old AAA variety store. I probably said that wrong, I'm sorry, in Coldwater. Additionally, they opened Hensley's in Union City. It was their hope that this scholarship would provide deserving students in Branch County some financial support in furthering their education. Since 2010, the Hensley Trust has awarded $352,000 in scholarships to Branch County students. This year, the Trust is awarding $32,000 to Branch County students. 17 scholarships in the amount of $1,000 are being awarded to Coldwater High School students, for a total of $17,000 today. On behalf of Southern Michigan Bank and Trust, trustee of the Hensley Scholarship Fund, We would like to award the following recipients with this scholarship: Brandon Michael Jones. And I'm sorry, but Bushra Ahmed. Carolyn Ann Miller. Carson Snyder. Charlotte Ann Calhoun. Dawson Brown. Gaith Musa. Liam Emery Van Wagner. Liam Boland. Matthew Nichols. Morgan Dancer. Rohan Singh. Rekia Manasser. Did I say it right? Taylan Eberts. Taylor West. Wa'il Abdullah. And Gabriella Bookmeyer. The second award we're presenting tonight is the George and Sadie Jewell Scholarship Fund. The fund was created by George and Sadie Jewell, obviously. They wanted to encourage students here in Branch County to pursue education opportunities beyond high school and be rewarded for their hard work. The Jewell family owned and operated Jewell Drugstore in Coldwater for many years. This scholarship is a one-time award to any Branch County resident attending a Michigan college or university. Since 2010, the George and Sadie Jewell Scholarship Fund has awarded $2,333,000 for Branch County graduates to continue their education. This year, the George and Sadie Jewell Scholarship Fund is awarding $295,000 in scholarships to Branch County graduates. 24 scholarships in the amount of $5,000 are being awarded to Coldwater High School graduates this year for a total of $120,000. On behalf of Thank you. On behalf of Southern Michigan Bank and Trust, trustee of the George and Sadie Jewell Scholarship Fund, we would like to award the following recipients with this scholarship: Abigail Govier. Aisha Abdullah. Cooper Nelson. Ezeldine Ahmed. Gracie Finn. Hannah Stevens. Ian Stowe. Okay. Jayla Sloan.
Kalud Ahmed. I'm sorry. Kimberly Tovar. Lily Bakan. Madison DeLong. Maram Al-Ghabri. Maya Walensky. Natalie Wilson. Grace Johnson. Stephen Covell. Zachary Coffing. Catalina Cardenas. And Owen Mitchell. Alumni receiving this award are Abigail Steele, Alexa Omo, Karen Mancera, and Jonathan Nietzwicki. Okay, we're at the last one for me. Next, we're going to give out the Shackleton Family Scholarship. The Shackleton Family Scholarship Fund was created by Sydney Shackleton for the benefit of deserving students from Bronson and Coldwater High Schools. Mr. Shackleton loved the arts and wanted to provide opportunities for students with that same passion to pursue their dreams. To be eligible for this scholarship, the student must be a resident of Branch County, attend Bronson or Coldwater Community Schools, have a high scholastic record, and be pursuing a degree in the arts, theater, music, architecture, design, or other related degrees. Recipients may only receive this scholarship once. Since 2011, the Shackleton Family Scholarship Fund has awarded $117,150 to Branch County students. This year, the trust is awarding $22,500 to Branch County students. Three scholarships in the amount of $7,500 are being awarded to Coldwater High School students for a total of $22,500. Southern Michigan Bank and Trust, trustee of the Shackleton Family Scholarship, would like to present the following recipients with this scholarship. Stephen Covell. Addison Arbor. And Natalie Wilson. Where am I at? I'd like to introduce Mrs. Rachel Horde for the Coldwater Education Association Scholarship.
Hi, I'm Rachel Horde, and I'm Vice President of the Coldwater Education Association. Our CEA has been doing our scholarship program for 15 years, and we were able to raise over $5,000 this year. This year's recipients are Sharifa Abuali, Eric Rucker, Maya Walensky, Mariam Al-Ghabri, Adam Hussein, Owen Callahan, Hannah Stevens, and Taylor West. Our next presenter is for the Jack and Sally Gates University of Michigan Memorial Scholarship. Mr. Aiden Derschel.
Hi, I'm Aiden Derschel. I'm here to present the Jack and Sally Gates Memorial Scholarship on behalf of the family. Jack and Sally were my great-grandparents, and although I never got to meet my great-grandfather, my great-grandmother shared many stories, so I always felt like I knew him. Jack Gates was a 1943 graduate from Coldwater High School and had a great admirer for the University of Michigan. He passed away November 2nd, 1983. It was in that year that the family and friends of Jack Gates started a scholarship to be awarded in memory, asking that the recipient be one who attends or is currently attending the University of Michigan. Although he did not attend the University of Michigan, he loved the U of M, especially football. He never missed a game. My great-grandmother, Sally Gates, was also a 1946 graduate of Coldwater High School, and she was a valedictorian of her class. She passed away on March 30th, 2021, and it was at this time that we changed the name of the scholarship to honor her as well. She was also a great fan of the University of Michigan. Selection of the recipient this year was made by my grandmother, Terry Ann Whelan, and we are happy to announce that this year Jack and Sally Gates University of Michigan scholarship recipient is Hannah Stevens. Next up is Mr. John Petzko.
Good evening. This is a fun night, especially if you're a parent, because you're thinking of all of this lovely green stuff that's floating down around your kids. But to you, I would say this. Thank you, as having been a long time teacher here at Coldwater High School, I always enjoyed this night because it recognizes the hard work that you people have put in to help make them be the successful people that they are. And I'm one of you because I have very successful daughters, and it's part of the reason that my family put this scholarship together. In 2008, my youngest daughter graduated from Western Michigan University. What was interesting about that is we were at the Brickyard, which is a golf course that goes into the Indianapolis 500 racetrack, and she was participating in the MAC championships because she played for Western. On that same day, the last day of the tournament, she happened to put on her cap and gown and walked down the 18th fairway, played her last hole in her cap and gown because her classmates were graduating on that same day at Western. And my wife said to me, you know, we should do something because Coldwater High School has been such a great institution for our daughters. Both of my daughters were very successful students and very successful golfers. There are three large state championship pictures in the athletic lobby that recognize the state championships that we won in 1999, 2000, and 2001. They got great educations here, and they went on to become very successful people. Jennifer, my oldest, graduated in the year 2000. She was salutatorian of her class. She also happened to receive the very prestigious and the first recipient from Coldwater to receive the Michigan High School Athletic Association scholarship recognizing an athlete from Coldwater High School. Her senior year, she was named to the Dream Team in the state of Michigan, which is one of the top eight golfers in the state. My youngest daughter, she was a typical high school student. But she was first team All-State for 4 years. So they had exceptional careers here. My oldest daughter went on to play for the University of Michigan. My youngest daughter, as I said, played at Western, had very successful careers there, and moved on in life. My oldest daughter is an academic advisor and gotten kudos and recognitions at Michigan State University. My youngest daughter happens to be a lobbyist working in a very successful lobbying firm after she got her law degree in Lansing, Michigan. So they have become very successful people, and it all started here. And that's something that for you people, it's a challenge to you to see if you can go on and become successful in your lives and make things happen that way. All right, my youngest daughter, like I said, she was a decent student here. Shocked my wife and I because she was named Academic All-American her senior year at Western Michigan University, which is quite a prestigious and difficult thing to become. So in that, we established a scholarship that recognizes somebody that plays golf, didn't have to necessarily be on the team, and the criteria was that you have to write a nice essay, which I then send to my daughters. And in typical parent-child relationships, my daughters start yelling at me that this is really difficult, and I tell them, suck it up, you gotta make a decision, which they ultimately do. This year, they decided that there were three, actually, it was really difficult. They picked three scholarships, so we're giving away three $500 scholarships this evening. This year's candidates, like I said, it was very difficult for my daughters. But the three that are going to be recognized tonight and get $500 scholarships are Talon Eberts, Cooper Nelson, and Haley Price. Well, and that's for you. Congratulations. Oh, Talon, hold on. Let you do this. There you go. Congratulations. Thank you. Oh, Haley?
That's for you.
Thank you. At this time, I would like to recognize Louise Christ, who's giving out the Christ Family Scholarship.
Congratulations to the class of 2024. We are the family of Jillian Christ. She was a 2010 CHS graduate who lived life to its fullest. She taught us to never take ourselves so seriously, to laugh out loud, say I love you often, and never pass up a chance to hug and kiss your parents goodnight. She had an outrageous, funny sense of humor. She was smart, beautiful, and passionate about her friends and family, animals, old people, and babies. Being educated at home until sixth grade made her appreciate her classmates even more when she joined public school. She didn't tolerate bullies. She had friends from diverse backgrounds, and she was one of those people who would sit with the lonely kid at school, cheer them up, and help them feel extra special. She never knew a stranger. Jillian's dream was to become a neonatal nurse. She was taking her nursing school prerequisites in 2011 when she was involved in a car accident just 17 months after graduating from high school. In the blink of an eye, she got accepted to the University of Heaven, and suddenly we had to give her back to God. She was 19 years old, not much older than most of you. After the initial horrific shock, we didn't know what to do with all that love we had for her. Where would it go now? We found that when we get overwhelmed by missing her physical presence, finding an outlet for our love to go is the key to our healing. Love is so important because it never dies. Every one of the memorial scholarships handed out tonight exist because families found somewhere for that love to go. Please remember that when you spend the checks on your education. We're investing the love we had for them in you because we think that you will make this world a better place just as they did. Our scholarships help future healthcare professionals, and as a nurse myself, I can tell you the world needs more of those. The pandemic took a toll on many of us, but it's been especially brutal on the medical profession. We've seen record numbers of retirement as a result. Please give those who work in healthcare an extra thank you next time you see them. Tonight is a milestone for us. We've awarded over $25,000. Our 100th scholarship since Jillie's passing will be awarded tonight, to a young lady who wasn't even born yet when her parents taught our daughter in Sunday school. They loved her name and told us way back in the 90s that if they had ever had a daughter, they would name her Jillian. So this one is extra special indeed. Jillian Hover is in college for biopsychology, cognition, and neuroscience. These kids are crazy smart. Supporting the physical and mental health of her community, and this is her second Jillian Crisp Memorial Scholarship. Jillian, are you here tonight? Our next alumni goes to Riley Rice, who's attending Hope College, majoring in exercise science and playing softball. Kara Volkmer, I don't know if Kara's here tonight, she's going to Michigan State studying nursing, and I hope she finds it as rewarding as my daughter and I both do. Our final alumni renewing the scholarship tonight is Sydney Gallup, who's studying dentistry at the University of Michigan and lights up a room with her smile. Sydney, are you here? Three Coldwater High School seniors will also be awarded scholarships tonight. Maya Walensky aspires to be a clinical psychiatrist who can help young people through the mental health struggles, which are rampant in adolescence and young adulthood. See here. Bray Muhammad will someday make a difference in countless lives as a cardiac physician's assistant. And our last scholarship goes to a young lady that I've watched develop into an amazing leader, friend, and athlete. Like our Jilly, she was captain for the CHS Gymnastics. She will owe her brother a milkshake when there is a cure for diabetes. And if anybody can help find that cure, it's going to be Charlotte Calhoun. Your lives all look so promising. Please make them count. And if the recipients would meet me over there under that sign at the end of the presentation tonight, that'd be great. Thank you.
Hello, I am Beth Carney, and I am here to represent the class of 1985. I can't even remember how many years ago that was that I graduated because it's too many fingers, and anyway, it was a long time ago. But what's really cool, I think, about Coldwater High School is there's generations of people that go to school here. So Mr. Petzko was my teacher here at school, and he really did a lot to inspire me to want to become a teacher, and I too became a history teacher. Coach Schweitzer was here when I was here at school, so the legacy of Coldwater High School really does go on, and I do hope that you all can take a moment to just recognize the greatness that is in this building and in this community. You are very blessed to be a Cardinal. The class of 1985 established a scholarship with very little money. We had very little left over at the end of our graduating year, and we decided that we wanted to start a scholarship. So it took a number of years for that money to accrue so that we had enough to give away, and I believe our first scholarship was probably $250. Our scholarship now tonight is $900, so when you invest your money wisely, guys, it comes back to you. We look for someone in the class who exudes what we think it means to be a Cardinal, a leader, compassionate, striving to be the best that they can possibly be. In our personal statement, this young woman said, "At the core of my being lies a profound goal, to extend a helping hand to those in need." That's a beautiful self-statement, and her teachers back it, saying that she has integrity, character, academic excellence, extremely active member, sharp analytical mind, communicates with passion and logic. So Sharifa Abololi, come on down.
Hey, good evening. I'm Ted Davis, and I am the principal here at Coldwater High School. I have the privilege of handing out 8 different awards today. So I will go ahead and get started. The first one that I will be doing is the Coldwater Exchange Club. Members of the Coldwater Noon Exchange Club would like to congratulate all students on your upcoming graduation and wish you the best regarding your future endeavors. The club's mission is to inspire communities to become better places to live, and our motto is Unity for Service. Within the last 20 years, we've donated over $15,000 to Coldwater Community Schools for various purposes and an additional $25,000 in scholarships. As always, there were many deserving applicants, and choosing just 2 was difficult. The first criterion was that the applicant attend Kellogg Community College. Other factors considered were work ethic, grades, and the likelihood that that student will complete their course of study. Please join me in congratulating Talon Eberts and Jayla Sloan. Quincy American Legion Post 157, founded in 1924, has been the cornerstone for the community for the past 100 years. The auxiliary is proud to award a $500 scholarship to Grady Brockway in recognition of the service and support his grandparents have given to Quincy American Legion. The mission of the American Legion Auxiliary is to support the American Legion and to honor the sacrifice of those who serve by enhancing the lives of our veterans, military, and their families, both at home and abroad. In spirit of service, not self, we honor Grady Brockway. The Pioneer State Mutual Insurance Company and Branch Insurance Agency Merit Scholarship. To be eligible for the Pioneer State Mutual Insurance Company and Branch Insurance Agency Merit Scholarship, a Coldwater High School senior needs to be pursuing a degree in business, management, or a related field and have been accepted to an accredited college or university. This year's recipient is planning on attending Northwood University. This year, the recipient of the $1,000 merit scholarship goes to Miss Mackenzie Scheid. The Branch County Chapter of the Michigan Association of Retired School Personnel has awarded thousands of dollars to to many outstanding seniors in Branch County over the last 31 years. This year's Coldwater recipient, Aisha Abdullah, plans to become an educator when she enters college this fall. Aisha has countless growing recommendations saying she is willing to try new things and that she is an extremely hard worker. Aisha's teachers describe her as one who stands out for her passion for the education profession, her desire to learn, and her ability to relate to all children at different ages and stages. These are all excellent qualities for a future educator. The Michigan Association of Retired School Personnel awarded their scholarship at the April meeting and once again sends their congratulations to Aisha this evening. The C. Lester Luce Scholarship was initiated in 1969 by then principal of Coldwater High School, C. Lester Luce. It was his concept that through this scholarship, the community could show its support of graduating seniors desiring to go to college. In that first year, $400 was awarded to a deserving student. Over the years, the family has asked that the selection be made by the current high school principal in honor of C. Lester Luce. This year, the C. Lester Luce Scholarship is proudly given to Sharifa Abuwali. John R. Vance, a 1975 graduate from Coldwater High School and a 1979 graduate from the University of Michigan, passed away in 1982. A fund in his memory was established by his family and many friends. This award may be used by the recipient to offset matriculation fees, tuition, and other fees for entering and studying at the University of Michigan. Tonight, we're pleased to award Hannah Stevens in honor of John R. Vance. Mr. E. Byron Thomas was a former Coldwater High School principal and superintendent. Mr. Axner Olson was Lake Middle School principal and business manager for Coldwater Community Schools. Both families have contributed funds to this scholarship and have requested the name of the scholarship never be changed. The description reads, "The recipient should be a needy, deserving, and worthy student who exhibits sincere desire to enter elementary or secondary education. This year's recipient exceeds these qualifications. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Aisha Abdullah." Since its founding in 1881 by visionary leader Clara Barton, the American Red Cross has been the nation's premier emergency response organization. Over the years, the organization has expanded its services, always with the aim of preventing and relieving suffering. According to their website, some 4 million people give blood, the gift of life. Through the Red Cross, making it the largest supplier of blood and blood products in the United States. We are pleased to present one exceptional senior student tonight with the scholarship earned through service to American Red Cross. Our recipient tonight will be recognized for their part in organizing our 23-24 blood drive held this spring here at Coldwater High School. This student, in charge of planning, recruiting, organizing, volunteering all aspects of the blood drive. We are very happy to present the American Red Cross Scholarship to Grady Brockway. And at this time, I'll bring up Ms. Allen and Ms. Warner.
Thank you all so much. Sitting through all of this, it's just so impressive, all of your accomplishments. You guys, the class of 2024, you're going to do something. And all of you parents, congratulations to you as well. So, yeah. Go for it. So I'm here tonight with my niece, Lindsay Eslow, and the current and brand new art teacher, Chelsea Wilbur, to present the Mary Jo Allen Memorial Award for Outstanding Achievement in Art. So this is a scholarship, an award, memorial award that we established in 2021 after our mom's death. She was an art teacher here for her entire career and is a Coldwater Cardinal, was a Coldwater Cardinal herself as our entire family, going back generations, actually. So when someone was speaking about the legacy here at Coldwater High School, it's a very strong one. I think I just lost. Something happened. I can project. I don't know.
Try that.
Okay. Are we back on? Yeah. All right. So she graduated from Coldwater High School in 1952, went on to study at Michigan State to receive a degree in art education, and came right back home and started teaching in 1956 here. Well, I think we're going to have trouble. So she came back to continue teaching and begin her career.
That's okay.
Is it me?
No.
Are they here? Right up here?
Oh, there they are. Perfect.
She began her teaching career here at CHS in 1956 and then went on to teach for many, many years at the middle school. And really, her passion was very much about spreading art and creative thinking through all students she had contact with. And that was something that was very, very important to her. And so it's been our honor to establish this award in her honor to continue that process moving forward. As I said, she was very much dedicated to inspiring and supporting all students, whether they were her art students or not. And we are very, very pleased to present the award this year to a young man that we actually have a bit of a family connection with, which has not been true before. So this makes this award tonight very, very special. One thing that I wanted to mention, when my mom retired from her teaching career, she continued her studies in art and continued to, she always said that once she was done teaching, then she could really do her art. So that's what she's done. And the very last thing that she completed before she died, very fittingly, we think, is a beautiful watercolor of Coldwater cardinals. So our recipient tonight will be receiving a print of that piece, as will Chelsea Wilbur, our brand new art teacher here, to commemorate this award. So we're very, very excited, actually, that you all have, you know, had the opportunity to have such a wonderful and inspiring art teacher. She very much reminds me of my mom. So that's so wonderful. So our recipient is Owen Callahan. Yes. Owen is going on to study at Adrian College, and he has all kinds of things he's planning to study, including art. So we are very, very pleased that we get to give this to Owen tonight. Thank you all.
Good evening. I'm Ron Lanford, a veterinarian at the Care Center Hospital, and it's my honor to give the final award for tonight, the Care Center Hospital Science and Mathematics Achievement Award. This award is selected by the teachers in the advanced placement classes of science and math, and Mr. Ryan Sheets gave me some of their thoughts on this recipient. This year's recipient of the award has challenged herself academically in every discipline available here at Coldwater High School. She has taken advanced placement classes in calculus, chemistry, psychology, biology, computer science, government, comparative government, physics, literature, and language. Her intellect is only surpassed by her willingness and perseverance to find success. When she encounters obstacles, she resets and works until her standard of success is achieved. She's an outstanding student leader involved in the NHS, National Honor Society, Student Council, Interact, and in soccer. Her intellectual talents combined with her determination will undoubtedly bring her the same level of success in her post-secondary education as she has achieved at Coldwater High School. I'm honored to present the Care Center Hospital Science and Math Award of $1,000 to Hannah Stevens.
Hey, before we conclude tonight, we do have one more award, and at this time, I would like to bring Petty Officer Devin Barks up to the podium.
Good evening, Coldwater. How are we doing today? Yeah, we having a good evening? That's great. I said my name is Petty Officer Devin Barks. I've been in the United States Navy for almost 18 years now. I also have Petty Officer Parker Talent with me, who's been in the Navy for about 5 years. We're here to give away a scholarship to an individual of one of your classmates. I believe he's called an alumni. He's a 13-year. Is that right? You guys call him alumni? All right, fantastic. Liam Van Wagner has been selected for the Naval Recruit Reserve Officer Training Corps scholarship. It is a full ride scholarship to North Carolina State. For this scholarship, it is a $200,000 scholarship. If he decides to go to a STEM academic field, he will get a $300,000 scholarship. This will automatically turn into him becoming a promoted officer in the United States Navy, which I believe is a big earmark in your community. I don't know how many officers have come out of Coldwater, but he is one of your future officers in the United States Naval. I'd like to say a bravo, Zulu. Thank you so much. Have a good evening.
Okay, before we conclude, just a couple of quick thank yous. Number one, thank you to all the presenters tonight for taking time out and presenting and helping us celebrate all the accomplishments of our students. Thank you to all of the generous donors who have donated all of the scholarships and the families that were involved in that selection. I'd also like to thank Jessica Grzanski for really organizing this and, well, giving me the script I needed to read and things like that. So I really appreciate all the hard work and time and effort that she's put into that. I'd also like to congratulate our amazing students. Amazing. What we have, close to $500,000, I think, in scholarships tonight. Just amazing. I also want to point out, too, if you want to get some pictures right after this is over, we do have the Coldwater Cardinal backdrop. If you want to use that to take some pictures and things like that, you're welcome to do that. Thank you for coming out tonight, and I hope you have the best day ever.